Welcome to Talk Tennis.
Woo! Yeah.
Troy is back. It's been a minute. Welcome. Thank you for joining me.
It's good to be back in the booth.
We're out here. We have so many exciting updates coming, but they haven't happened yet. But it's been a little bit of a struggle to playtest podcast with the playtest team lately. So to our audience, stay tuned. Exciting changes and like a little bit of a remodel coming your way.
Yeah, I want to say summer's here. Today, the weather's not necessarily showing it.
Cold.
I know. Michelle wants the sun and the heat.
We're doing tan girl summer.
I actually don't mind the June gloom a little bit.
Oh, no.
Makes me feel like I'm in Wimbledon or something.
You know, okay.
A gloomy day.
Yeah. But we have so much to catch up on because I think last time we talked, it was January. Well, I mean, last time we talked was like yesterday. Okay. People listening don't realize that like Troy and I work like not even 10 feet from each other. So we talk often. However, last time we podcasted, I think was January. Was it January?
Before it's been BNP. A little while. It's been a little while.
Oh, man. Okay. It was like Breakpoint was just coming out. And then the second half just came out. No spoilers.
Yeah. That was a bit ago.
It was a bit ago. So a lot's happened since then. And we're going to talk about pro stuff. Pro, allegedly, what's happening. And some true things that are happening, like gear and stuff, allegedly. Because endorsing.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
We're what's all going down on the tour? So what's going on the tour? Right now,
we're on the tour.
I'm stoked that we got the grass court tennis on TV.
Yes.
At this moment. I love the clay court season, but like watching tennis on TV, I've always talked about like clay court tennis isn't necessarily the funnest to watch for me on TV. Just one, because I guess like just the vividness of the picture, like on clay, you can't really track the ball as well. The court's got some discoloration and the background, the ball doesn't really pop. And then as soon as the grass court comes, and especially when the courts are like fresh and not worn down, that bright green, you see the ball clearly. It's just different.
Yeah.
And then for me too, it's shorter points, not as much of a grind. So I don't know. I love watching this time of year with the grass courts. I wish, and I know this is a kind of a debate on the tour, but I wish this longer. Grass court season was longer.
Totally.
I feel like.
Bring it back. Make it longer.
We have so many hard court tournaments and the clay court season goes on for a decent amount of time that we could probably cut a week or two, maybe somewhere in there and add.
Right.
But I guess maybe part of that more grass court tournaments is the resources and the availability. I don't know. You know, there's not a ton of grass court clubs and a host site for more, I guess. But in a dream world,
we're right. Petitioning to have a grass court tournament out in the desert where there's some grass courts.
Yeah, more grass court tournaments and bring Roger back.
Bring Roger back! Speaking of Roger... Yesterday, so I said this out loud, and someone was like, no, it's in August. I was like, is it not Roger Federer Day? Because Halle started,
Yeah.
That's like the Roger Federer tournament.
Yeah, he played it or won it like 10 times or something. But I that's what I thought at the Halle tournament, they were going to have like a day dedicated to him at the tournament.
It was yesterday,
and they did a little ceremony for him and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. We have someone in our office who keeps threatening to get an RF tattoo. I'm going to put him on blast. He has not gotten the tattoo, and he told me it was not RF day, and I think that now he needs to go get that tattoo for not being
crazy.
The biggest fan. Yeah.
What if, not saying I would do it, but how would you feel if somebody did an RF tattoo and then also...
Oh, man!
Did a Rafa Bull tattoo, like one on each arm or one on each calf.
Respect the goats,
I guess. Is that like, that'd be not good in your book?
I feel like you cannot, I don't know. Can you be a Roger and a Rafa fan equally?
I feel like I'm pretty close.
Really? I know.
One tattoo on each arm and they get like fed all on the back.
One's like the devil and one's angel. I don't know. I'm fed. I'm team fed. Right. Period.
I guess if you threw all three and you put like a Novak logo on then you'd be like,
just... We kind of started having that discussion. You missed it the other day about Rafa, Fed, and then Djokovic. And it was kind of like some people were kind of just going to bat for Djokovic. Like he just doesn't have the Rafa Fed fans. But like, I know his fans are like extreme Djokovic fans too, but they've got such their own rivalry. And like Djokovic obviously has been breaking records and doing amazing things, but like almost is kind of like left behind in the rivalry now. Yeah. It's like, okay, bye. Like he's kind of like, bye, old man. And I'm a Fed fan. Okay, so don't come at me. I don't know.
I mean, it's tough. But I mean, the one thing Novak definitely has going for him in the argument is just the titles and the accolades, you know?
It's like resilience and like stamina. And that's what I brought to the table is like, he's hard to relate to as a tennis player because he's doing all these amazing things and he's like such a physical specimen of an athlete, and like also his rehab and his eating and like everything's so extreme that it's hard to be like, yeah, I can relate to him. Like I don't sleep in a chamber or like what was the thing he was wearing at the French Open?
Like some sort of monitor?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's awesome. I got my Garmin and that's about it.
Yeah.
Like,
it's almost, yeah, I see where you're going with that. Almost like the science and like that part of his regimen is almost like too much sometimes.
Unattainable. Like, yeah. Like even if you started fresh from right now, like that is something that I do not feel like I could ever be on the same level or even the same playing field. Right. Like it's just a whole, he is in a class of his own.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's crazy.
Yeah. And then like, I guess as a Roger, you're definitely a Roger fan. I'm a Roger fan. But like his level of like natural talent and God gifted,
100%,
you know, just talent that he has in his hand. Like that's almost sort of unattainable, but that's what like a lot of us Fed fans or, you know, Fed fanboys out there. We got one in the office.
I know.
That just want to emulate his strokes.
That's what I was
going
to say. But then you see people and you're like, oh, that guy obviously likes Federer, his stroke, you know, it's very much based on what he plays like. And then you're like, I want to wear his shoes. I want to wear his clothes. And now post ATP career, he's doing all these cool things. Like now he has his sunglasses. I mean, obviously all this stuff with On. And it's just like so kind of fun to see that he's still thriving. And I've said this before, like he isn't going anywhere. He's still pretty relevant, thankfully.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's awesome.
Is it rumor or has it been said that he might be doing some like On or TV commentating?
He's wearing some On court, while he's on TV.
Yeah, like TV commentating in the booth.
I thought so.
Yeah. I wasn't sure if that was like out in the public or the internet or if that was like.
Roger Federer speaks out on shocking commentary role. No plans to commentate this year, Federer responded. Come on, Roger. Watch him just like pop in though. Like, literally just pop in.
Yeah.
Also, I am going to give a shout out because all of the French Open, I every day gushed about how much I love French Open radio. And I am so excited for Wimbledon radio because I think it's a lot of the same commentators and they are awesome. Just, I don't know why I had to say that, but I had to say that. That's all.
Yeah, no, it's cool to listen to them.
Yeah, I don't know if anyone out there like listening to our podcast also listens to the radio versions of the Grand Slams, but especially there is actually a bit of a debate going on in American tennis right now, and it has to do with the availability of watching matches on TV. I don't know if you've heard any of this.
No, but make it easier.
Make it easier. And that's kind of been the topic. It's been really hard for people. Like, you might have one service provider and they might not have the Tennis Channel, or you might have Tennis Channel Plus, but you can't access a certain match. And like, it's kind of come up. I've seen a lot of other people and creators talking about this, and I'm just going to give a shout out to like the free services like the radio stations that literally commentate point by point, play by play, and it's so entertaining. So that's what I listen to all French Open.
Yeah, as a tennis fan, I wish it was easier access on TV. You know, it's like, yeah, I've like had DirecTV for a long time, and like but it's really expensive to get that package that has the Tennis Channel. Yeah. It's not on like the regular package. Not having that anymore, and then, you know, you got to get like Tennis Channel Plus for the yearly subscription, which is good, but like I just wish it would, because like even like I mean, like pickleball has been on TV and it, like, it'll be on Tennis Channel, but then it'll also be on like CBS Sports and stuff like that, so
make
it's like,
it stop, sorry.
It's just like I wish it was on other channels sometimes.
Yeah,
Yeah, like I find it on Direct on like Bally Sports, but that's another one that's like an added package.
That's for sure an added package. So there's been a bit of debate. So we're here to say, make it easier. Give us more tennis on TV or like free streams. Come on. Like we all know that this sport could use more people watching it. Like make it easier.
Yeah.
But that's all. What else? I kind of want to talk about any gear changes. There hasn't been like a ton, but let's just start with
one of the biggest ones that comes to my mind, just racket, because there's not a ton this time of year. Yes. A lot of times during this time of the year, they've already settled at the beginning and kind of are just
they're
fine,
in their contract.
Probably fine tweaking their string tension or whatever, but usually sticking with the frame. But Bublik on the ATP Tour, Sasha Bublik, went from his Yonex, which I believe is Ezo 98, to a Technifiber frame now.
That's a big move.
Kind of cool. He's doing pretty good on the grass courts. He just got a big win against, I think, Struff.
Yeah, that's a big win. But he needs a break, too, before Wimbledon.
Yeah.
I'm big on the, like, you do really well right before a major. You need to have a little time before the major starts.
Yeah.
He just did really well at Stuttgart.
Yeah. But, he's in Technifiber. Looks like a T-Fight frame.
Those are gonna ask.
I'm not sure the string pattern, so I don't know if it's, like, the 305 or the 315. Mm-hmm. But yeah, he's been playing pretty well, hitting good with Technifiber. I've been playing a lot with Technifiber frames. I like their frames a lot, both TF40 and T-Fight.
Yes.
I can like go back and forth. Those are a couple of my favorites. So
they're good. And Iga also re-signed with Technifiber.
Oh, okay.
So we know she's going to be, I think, was it a 6-year or 5-year deal? She'll be continuing with them. So that's nice to know.
Got some big bucks on that?
I don't know. I didn't see the numbers, but you know. I mean, number one player in the world, 3 out of 4. French Opens, right? That she's, I mean, like, hasn't she won the last 3 of the last 4 years?
I think so.
I don't know if I said that correctly.
I think so.
But yeah.
Yeah.
She just won her 3rd.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And her first one she won when she was playing Prince.
Yes.
And then the last 2 with Technifiber.
Yeah. And then we can talk about this maybe. Like, here's a little insight that maybe our listeners don't know because we asked our friends at ASICS. She's still rocking with the ASICS shoes, but she's head to
toe. She's still been playing Joe Raz.
She's, technically supposed to be head to toe on.
Yeah.
They have ASICS no longer is working with her, or at least she's not under contract, and she is under full on contract, but she's still using on shoes. So that's always interesting. And I'm very curious. I haven't had an opportunity to speak with anyone that works at On, but if they're going to be making her own shoe or what that's going to look like.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, will they have a signature or like a female specific line, or is it just going to be?
Because isn't Layla wearing On?
Yeah.
The Roger
I'm pretty sure she
Pro.
Was a Roger Pro model.
Yeah.
Looks like it.
And Ben Shelton.
Ben Shelton. Although he's definitely worn the Roger Pro sometimes. And then lately I seen one of his shoes that looked all white. So I don't know if it was like a prototype or just a different colorway. It was hard to tell without seeing it like right up close.
Right.
But,
which is cool because I think prototypes and stuff like test, like, I think that's cool. I know you're into the shoes too, but we also know how hard it can be to test a shoe in the middle of the season.
Yeah.
Especially when like you move like Iga, like she's sliding all over the place. And
I think that's why, I mean, a lot of pros hold on to stuff that's,
yeah,
you know, the cosmetic and the paint job sort of thing.
Yeah,
like they did. Some of them don't want to switch, and I could see especially during the season. But someone like that relies so much on her movement. Mm-hmm. I mean, we have a hard time giving up certain.
Yeah,
you've been using the same racket forever. but like, yeah, until they have something that's dialed and perfect, I think it's going to be hard for her to let go.
Especially, she is very intentional, I guess it would be a good word for her. So yeah, I could see that.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Speaking
of
like testing shoes though.
Yes.
When we were at Indian Wells and we had our demo court right in the middle of the practice court, which was pretty cool. One of the days Monfils was practicing right on the court next to us. And I noticed that he was changing his shoes during practice and he was testing out our Tango brand shoes. And he was doing it for a while, but then like I was watching him practice. I couldn't help but not pay attention. And he's out there sliding, running around, grinding. And after one of the slides, he like got up and like you could tell he was like frustrated. So he went over, took off the Artengos and then put his Joe Rez back on. But he was testing it at Indian Wells during practices.
Someone on YouTube told me Ortenga were the best shoes because I said that the Stalla Courts were. So whoever that was, please hit me up because it sounds like.
Yeah. Just saying. I don't have any experience with their shoes, but I do know some of their stuff that they sell is like kind of lower price point. So I wouldn't think, you know, the shoes would be like the highest grade, but who knows?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Speaking of Monfils, this came up during the French Open. Svitolina had a great little, not little, great, like she's been playing really well since she's come back. And it's been interesting to see. She is now rocking, I think, Adidas Ava Courts on her feet.
Yeah, at the French she was, right?
At the French, yeah. And then before the French even. And then she's wearing a sport brand that's made in the Ukraine. But that kind of came up and I had brought it up to conversation a few times with, does Monfils retire and just become Svitolina's traveling partner? Yeah. And like, let Svitolina, you know, she's the younger of the two, like keep her career going. She seems to be having some success. Just saying.
He'll be daddy daycare.
Yeah. And, daddy daycare on and, the WTA.
Cheerleader in the box, you know?
I mean,
he does that. Yeah. When he gets a good point. Yeah, he'll be doing that.
That would be awesome. That would be so cool, I think.
Who knows? But maybe don't throw in the towel on him yet. You know, maybe
what about a mixed doubles partnership?
Ooh, that could be tough. That's not always the best idea.
That might not end
to play competitively with your other half. That might, you know, you never know.
She's kind of got that look sometimes.
Yeah, like I could see a point going really well, like a really long grinding point.
And he like does a tweener and like messes
and
up.
Just misses and she just like, kicks him off and gets rid of him, finds a new partner. No, I'm just kidding. Who knows? They could be great partners, but I heard, you know, that can get a little messy, you know.
We should sometimes. Jay and Britt.
All right.
That's always fun. Who else? Let's see. There were a few. Oh, Grigor Dimitrov with Lacoste.
Yeah.
And we just put out a practice video of Dimitrov and Tommy Paul. I got to watch that practice at BMP and it was pretty funny, mainly because they both had just like this really funny banter and like Tommy Paul's coach is pretty entertaining. And then like the breakpoint people were there filming. So it was almost like they were kind of putting on a show a little bit, but brought up the fact that Dimitrov has a never ending supply of his vapors. And we were debating if he'll switch into Lacoste shoes. So,
yeah, so because so far he was still using the Nikes, Vapor 9 or whatever.
Yeah.
Once again, you know, like you switch to another brand, but I mean, even when he was at Nike, he wouldn't even switch to the newer Nike,
exactly.
It was like the old stock. So, and like sometimes, I don't know, my thought, you know, like sometimes you'll say, like, oh, you know, guys like Grigor or like who are some of the other, like Bencic, she was using the old.
Yep.
Like, you know, they'd have a never ending stock. It's like, I think Nike just keeps the mold and
that
keeps the recipe on deck for them and they just keep stock. They keep producing them for them. I don't know.
Well, allegedly,
right?
Allegedly, he asked for what Roger had.
Okay, like back when he was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And
with the way it was plated and shanked and all that.
And the mold was expensive. And I think it was like, okay, well, I'd want that and I'm paying for that. Yeah. And so he's got that. Like,
if I have to go my whole career being called baby fat, I better get his privileges.
That's what I was thinking. He just leaned in. So I thought that was interesting. I'm also very curious, do you think Lacoste will make him sleeveless outfits or practice?
I don't know about that. That doesn't seem like
Lacoste
style.
But
they've done some weird things. I mean, some of their shirts are very unique. Their polos. I haven't been a huge fan of that like new neck design they have for like Medvedev, where it's like a square neck. Yeah. Or something. I don't know. It's a little different.
It's different.
But most of their stuff over the years has been very clean, classic. You know, there's some players that look really, really well in it. You know.
Yeah.
Just suits them. So,
speaking of the cosplayers, we heard this week that Anna Kontaveit is going to be retiring after Wimbledon.
Yeah,
which is a bummer. But it's her back, and she basically admitted to the diagnosis and saying that like she's not able to practice the way she would want to, and that's just so crazy. Though she's like 27.
Yeah.
So crazy.
Like the whatever she has is limiting her from training and being able to develop and keep playing at that level. So mm-hmm. it's It's almost like...
It sucks. And she, I don't know her. I haven't really interacted with her ever, but she seems like one of those players that's really well-liked by like so many different players on tour. So it was cool to see the tour kind of like support her. And then everyone's like, can't wait to see what you do next. And that's kind of like the thing that I am excited to see. Like, what will she do next? Do you think she'll stay in tennis? Do you think she'll just kind of be normal and live her life? But we'll see.
Be nice to have her around. I remember watching one of her matches at Indian Wells on one of the outside stadiums. It wasn't like a fully packed crowd, but where I was sitting kind of baseline, there was like a big group, probably like 15-20 of like her friends, and then like people, I think they were from Estonia or where she's from, and they were just like going crazy for her. And it was kind of cool. Like, I was like right next to her, like,
she seems really easy to be friends with, which is cool.
And she was also talking about shoes, was one of those players that even when she went to Lacoste, she was using, she was one of the few on tour that would use the Rafa shoe, the Vapor Cage 4.
That's crazy.
Yeah. She was using that for a while. She did go to Lacoste shoes for a while, but she would like go back and forth to the Vapor Cage. Yeah. She used that shoe. So that's kind of unique.
Yeah. I just caught I just saw something. I was going to talk about Tiafo, and he's now in the top 10.
Yeah.
So Fritz and Tiafo.
First time American men. There's been two in the top 10 since, I think they said 2011.
That's pretty crazy.
Yeah.
So everyone that's been like, where's American tennis? Here.
Yeah.
It's here.
Yeah.
We're here.
Yeah, and he hasn't been far off from that, but he just slowly, you know, Fritz has been doing pretty well for a good amount of time now.
Yeah.
And Tiafo is like right on he's that cusp. Coming. Yeah.
Oh, I love him. I hope he does well the rest of the year. He will.
Yeah. I think he can do well at Wimbledon if he, I mean. Yeah.
And US Open.
Yeah.
I mean.
Especially, US Open. He's like done well there before.
Yeah. His gear hasn't really changed, though. He's still rocking the Nike with the V-Core Pro.
Yeah. And
GP turbos.
Still got the GPs.
Which I know everyone wants to get more of. We all love
Are we
them.
Getting any more GPs?
I think yes. And if it's not us, it's Europe. But there is a small launch. I think actually by the time this episode airs, they should be out.
They're going to be Naomi specific, right?
Yeah.
So hopefully they have big enough sizes that I can get me a pair.
Definitely.
I'll need like a size 11-ish, 11 and a half.
That was the funny thing about, I mean, not funny, but like they obviously Nike was creating, the brands create so far in advance that, you know, they had already created stuff for Naomi this year. And since she's not playing, it will still go out. So yes, GP turbos are on their way. Woohoo.
So comfortable. So
stock plush. Stock up now.
I've tried a lot of shoes in the time that the GPs got discontinued. And there's some comfortable ones, but nothing that has that like thick.
There's not.
Cushy midsole. Yeah. I mean, there's some comfy shoes out there. The Mizunos that we recently tested.
Those are comfy. Comfy. They're not as responsive.
But they're not like that like pillowy
and
soft.
Like, yeah. And not like as streamlined in my opinion.
Yeah. So.
What
I'm
else?
Have to, I'm going to have to go and sell, go in our sales and save me a pair.
Yeah, do it. Do it now. Actually, I should look. What else?
Rybakina?
Yeah.
Rybakina? I'm not sure if I say it right. Rybakina. If I was a commentator, do I say Rybakina, Rybakina?
Do you know what? And like the what I loved about the French radio, the French Open radio, which a lot of them were from the BBC. There's a couple from the US. They say things the way they want to, and they just like kind of owned it. And like, I am okay with that. It was funny. But anyways, Rybakina.
Yeah, so she's been Yonex rackets for a while now.
Yes.
Playing very well. But now she's head-to-toe Yonex
player.
That's
cool.
So I think as far as ranking goes, well, Casper's up there now too. Casper's like top five. And sometimes he slips under the radar, but he's a head-to-toe.
He's going to make a breakthrough this year. Bold prediction.
Stan was still head-to-toe, not as ranked as high as he used to be. And now
I'm going to give my bold prediction that I said it out loud earlier, but I didn't say it out loud. And now I'm going to say it, and it's going to be on record. And when it happens, you guys
don't tell
can
me
all
that Casper's going to win Wimbledon.
No, that's not bold. His court. That's
okay.
Not bold.
Okay. But still, it's not his style.
It is a Wimbledon prediction. Taylor Townsend is going to win Wimbledon.
In doubles.
Singles.
What?
Maybe doubles. Both?
Doubles for sure.
I am here for everything she is doing right now. She just posted something on Instagram and I am like, yes, queen. I have to pull it up because Sometimes she just gets it. I literally sent it to my sister, who's like, she loves tennis, but she's not in it the way we are. Taylor Townsend. She's been posting a lot of workout videos, first of all. She's
she's
crushing
like
it.
Killing it.
Allowing my light to shine is my biggest flex yet. And I'm like, yes, let's go. I am here for Taylor Townsend and everything she's selling. So her self-confidence, and I'm so, I don't know. So I think just even that, the way she's like leaning into it all, I'm here for it.
At the French, she was runner-up.
Yeah.
In finals. Mixed or women's?
In women's.
Okay, women's.
With Layla.
With Layla.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, for sure. Obviously, I think she's a top choice for doubles, whatever doubles she plays, women's or mixed.
She's been leaning into the doubles this year, but like, she's also been playing a lot of qualies and singles, and her game actually is meant for grass.
No, I think I'd be cool. I know she has that serve and volley aspect. She's a lefty, you know, she's got pretty good touch and feel. You know, I know some lefties that got good touch and feel.
I'm just saying, I'm just putting it out there.
But yeah, as far as winning, ooh, man.
Bold prediction. That's what I said.
Go to Vegas with that, man. You can come up.
I know.
But that'd be cool. That'd be super awesome.
Place your bets now. I got to ask about how that works. I don't do any of that stuff. Yeah.
Not so bold prediction. Novak wins Wimbledon.
Yeah.
I don't know. We'll see.
I've seen a lot of I've seen a lot of slipping in the last week on the grass. It's always that weird time of year where it's like, first of all, anyone listening, whoever's listening is listening. Anyways, I hate when I say that. Grass court shoes, not easy to come by, even when you're a pro. Fun fact.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I find so interesting. Like, top players that have full-on sponsorships still can't find grass court shoes sometimes. And it's like them having to go into a whole different shoe. That's so weird for like 3 weeks or four weeks.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right?
They'll just pick up whatever they can get their hands on.
Yeah, we were just talking about how like players are so specific about especially their footwear and their rackets. And then it's like, well, I need a grass shoe. What do you got?
Yeah.
Case is great. I'll take it. Bablat, great. I'll take it. Like, I know a couple of players that have had to switch into something because like certain brands only make for certain players and don't have allocation for anyways. So it's such a long story, but it's so interesting. That's an interesting side of the grass season too.
Yeah. Didn't we just recently get a style of grass court shoe here?
K-Swiss.
The Ultra Shot?
Is it here?
Yeah. Yes. I know the men's, we got like an Ultra Shot 3, I think.
Yes.
Which is like rare. Like we haven't had grass court shoes here for a long time.
Yes. Oh, are the women's here?
Tennis Warehouse Europe, we get some for sure.
Yes.
But I was like, Ultra Shot.
Yeah. But even Tennis Warehouse Europe, I think they only have K-Swiss, Head, and Babolat this year.
Okay.
And that's more than years past.
Yeah.
So I remember
a long time ago, a Fila coming in.
That makes sense. Yeah. That kind of makes sense. But that's such that always blows my mind too, where it's like you all of a sudden are transitioning, not just surface, but now you have to find the right equipment for that. So,
yeah. If you play grass courts here in the U.S.,
K-Swiss
Ultra Shot. And if they're going to put a grass outsole on a good shoe, I mean, that's a good one to go with.
Yeah.
Ultra Shots are awesome.
For sure. What else? Do we have any more? I keep thinking of things. Oh, something else I noticed. This is not like rumors or anything, but a lot of players have been traveling, obviously, and the airlines are losing their luggage. I know of 3 pros, and their luggage has been lost. And like, just
are these
lost.
like our sponsored players?
Some.
Or like, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh. Like.
Not a good season for travel right now.
Not a good season for travel. I'll give a shout out to Angela from USC, who played at USC.
Kulikov,
I was going to say, I'm going to mess up her last name. Kulikov. She she's practicing or warming up for Wimbledon in Italy. She's going on day 5 without her luggage.
Oh, man.
And then
she luckily maybe had her rackets, but just lost.
She had one racket with her. I hope she had her shoes. Or I think they actually were shipping to Europe, so someone brought them to her. But yeah, isn't that crazy? And then there was another player, Kasia Kawa. She uses the Prince Ripsticks.
Yeah.
Also, luggage lost, one racket.
Oh, man. That sucks.
Like, what?
Dang.
Yeah. So I don't know what's going on. I haven't traveled internationally in years, so I'm not an expert in that.
Yeah, but. Right. And like for carry-on, you can only take so much. So It's like, do you just take your five rackets and hold them in your chair? Or so, I don't know.
That's part of
your. And travel with your grass court shoes on. Like your absolute necessities.
Could you imagine if you like finally found a pair of grass court shoes and then they like got lost?
Yeah.
Oh, man. It's been crazy.
Because it's all part of it. But
wild times. Yeah. So I'm assuming, a lot of players are going to change the way they carry on, I guess, based on that. It's a bummer. So, and, shipping internationally isn't easy either.
Right.
And even shipping in Europe, throughout Europe, isn't easy. Or then shipping Europe to UK, it's not easy. So it's interesting.
Yeah, that's a trip. Something you don't really think about until you're in it yourself as a traveling pro.
Yeah.
Because like when we're doing we have our stores like at BNP and then we've done like San Jose and so like other tournaments and stuff I've been to. And it's like some of these players come in your store and are like, oh, I need 20 sets of Luxalon or I need overgrips. And you're like, wouldn't you always like think you would have it? But sometimes it's just last minute and you just need what you need and you just get it. It's like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was Angela was asking if we could overnight a reel of string to Italy, and it was a Sunday and Monday was a holiday, and I was like, no. And also, we can't just overnight things to Europe.
Yeah,
I don't think. I mean, we can't. And then there's vendor restrictions and everything else. It's a little messy. So that's been interesting to see. Some of the players are just kind of like, what happened to my gear? And then it's like. I've heard some of the players will talk about the laundry services at tournaments and they've like, there was a tournament, I can't remember which one, but there was one that was like notorious for mixing up the players' stuff. And like certain players were like posting on Instagram, like, have you seen a specific piece of their outfit? It was like a missing, in search of.
Yeah.
And like some of these players have really nice gear.
Oh, yeah.
Like I know like some of the girls on Team T-Dub now are sponsored by Viori. Like I'd be devastated. Or like the Lululemon girls, like I'd be so mad if like I lost a piece of that.
Yeah. I mean, and then the ones that you see like sometimes they travel like, players that aren't ranked very high that are grinding out on the challengers or whatever,
it's
and like
so meaningful.
A lot of them just wash their own clothes in their own bathtub or
totally.
Sea,
Yeah.
And like at that point, it's like you almost want to just do that just so you don't lose your stuff.
Yeah.
It's like,
so.
Damn.
What about shout out to Andrew Murray for being the oldest person? Oldest.
Andrew Murray? Or
Oh man, it's Thursday.
I think that's the second time that's happened in podcasts.
So there's a wine named Andrew Murray or a brewer.
A local winery.
There's a local winery.
It's wine tasting time.
It's like 2 o'clock on Thursday. Yeah. So I'm thinking about wine. What is in my cup? Andrew Murray rosé? No. Andy Murray. Shout out to Andy Murray for winning back-to-back challengers and becoming the oldest person on tour to win a challenger.
Yeah?
Yeah.
He like broke the age record?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Let's go, old people.
But yeah. Were those grass courts, both of them?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
And then the funny one, I know I talked about this, but like I think it was in the UK and his wife and kids came to watch his match, the finals. And then it like they had this huge rain delay, like thunder and rain. And so then they left. And then literally as they were leaving, they got back on the court. So they missed the whole match. They missed him.
Oh, dang.
And it was kind of funny. But yeah. And then Kei Nishikori.
Yeah, I didn't. I heard one of Andy's wins, and then after that, they were like, "K won a challenge." Yeah. Like,
so there's like a revival of the older guys, right?
I mean, at one point, like with Andy, you think like, okay, former 2-time Wimbledon champion.
Could you imagine seeing him in the draw?
Right. Yeah, and so he's like still out there grinding, playing challengers. It just goes to show, like to me, that just shows how much he loves the fight and the battle of competing. Like, ego aside, because there's some players I'd say over, some top pros that have that ego that would like, no, if I'm not winning tour level or 500s or 250s, I'm just going to walk away.
Mm-hmm.
But Andy just wants to scrap. Mm-hmm. Like, I was just telling guys in the office, like, you're going to play a 5-0. You want to play baseline games?
Yeah.
I'll tune you up, I'll give you a couple points and then I'll beat you, double bagel.
Yeah.
Like some people just love the fight. Rafa, he just loves the competition, the fight, And then, you know, Kay's situation is totally different. Not saying he's not a fighter, but like for him, he hasn't been on tour in like, I think they said over 2 years or something.
It's been a while. Yeah.
Maybe not that long, but to come back to play a challenger and to win it like right away, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Like just to get a couple wins under your belts, tough after that long.
That's what I was going to say.
He came back and won a challenger. I mean,
that,
that's
that nervous feeling that you get when you're like serving to close something out and you're like,
yeah, I thought it was pretty surprising. Like, oh, he won a challenger.
Yeah, yeah, that's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, that's, I think that's about it. Sponsorship list, should I like check out what's in here? I mean, it's been pretty much the same. Well, and then of course, like someone always shows up and something else and the rumors fly. And
so you're going with Taylor Townsend to win Wimbledon singles on the women's side.
Yeah.
Who are you going to go with on the men's side? Who do you want to win?
Who
Not
do
saying
I want to win?
You think's going to win. Like Roger. I obviously would say, right?
There's no other answer. I don't know. I have to look.
Tiafo?
I could go with Big Tiafo. Foe? Why? I mean, why not? Why not him? Let's keep it in the U.S. The U.S. of A.
Yeah, who'd you pick for French?
Who's I picked Casper.
Oh, Casper. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think Grass is quite. I mean, I think he could have a good run. I just don't think.
I need.
It's his. Obviously, the way he hits the ball and stuff, I don't think it's like his best chance to win a major.
I need like a new ATP. I mean,
the one I'm excited to watch, and hopefully, I hope he has a good run. He's been injured or whatnot a little bit here and there, but I'm hoping Korda.
Oh, I like him.
I mean, he is a beautiful game. I think grass could be good surface for him. He can strike it flat. He hits hard. So I'm hoping he does well on the women's side. I don't know.
Oh, speaking of not allegedly, but true, and I know you don't like this topic, but I was looking at the rankings. Tsitsipas and your girl are together. And do you feel like it's messing with his game?
It's a distraction?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
He's we'll just see. So happy with his love life that he doesn't care what happens.
He's getting complacent.
Yeah. I keep looking up when he's playing and he's not winning.
Yeah. I don't know.
I don't either.
It'll be hard to say.
Yeah, Badosa.
And then she's just coming back. Like, she's injured, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I saw her hitting balls on social media, but I don't think she's, like, ready to play
it. Is she not playing Wimbledon?
I don't know.
I don't know.
She and didn't seem like she
Tomjanovic
was
too.
Doing a drill where she was like very isolated, not moving.
Oh, shoot. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. And then, yeah, Isla would be coming back. I think she keeps pushing it back. She was supposed to come back for the French, I thought, and then pushed it back. We'll see.
Yeah. It's interesting on the women's side. I mean, obviously, I would put Rybakina up there as one of the top. She's won it.
Yeah.
Sabalenka, you would think, but like.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. She maybe not finding her rhythm right. Maybe it'll pick up, but she just lost to Kudermetova.
I feel like she obviously like plays with more emotion, and there's been some like ups and downs with stuff lately. At the French, they call it the Naomi rule. So now players are allowed to like not go to a press conference if they feel like it would kind of mess with their mental health. And so at the French, she opted to not go to one of the press conferences.
Yeah, I saw that. And she didn't get fined?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, it's like a new thing.
And is it like so many per tournament?
I don't know. Like I wonder too. Yeah. And I think some of the questioning and like stuff and dramas around all that might, I mean, I could see that a little bit messing with her because like, I love her. Like, and I think why I love her is because that is relatable to me. She's not the most mentally strong, but for someone like that, I'm just using myself as an example. Like, it would be hard to not have that in the back of your head. Yeah. Like, oh, people are thinking this or that or whatnot. So,
yeah.
Depending on, also, we have to mention the fact that this year, last year, there was no points at Wimbledon. So everyone coming in basically is like, competing.
That was last year?
Yeah, there were no points last year.
Rybakina won.
And the Belarusians and the Russians couldn't play last year. So there you go. Oh, so maybe that gives her a vendetta. Like maybe she's like, hey, you forgot about me.
Maybe.
But maybe not. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think one person that a lot of us would like to see win it, and hopefully she's fully healthy, is Ons.
Yes.
That'd be cool.
That would be so cool.
I think the grass is a good surface for her.
Oh, yeah. That'd be cool.
That'd be cool. She lost in the final to, was it last year?
Yes, to Rabagina, yeah. Right? Yes.
I know she's made the final before.
And it wasn't a very good final, was it?
I don't think so.
No, because I wanted it to be better. That would be cool.
But who knows? There's a lot of players out there that could do it.
And
like Taylor Townsend.
Right? I mean, Stranger Things. There have been some rule changes in Wimbledon, you know, for 2023. Like
colors?
So this is, I don't want to make you uncomfortable, but
can Kyrgios rock his red J's and a red hat? Or?
So women are finally allowed to wear color under their skirt.
Like their undergarments?
Yes. So it doesn't have to be all white. No. Like this is literally 2023 and this is the first time that that's been allowed. I don't know if there are other rules. I'm sure there are, but
yeah.
I was laughing when I heard like the discussion of this. It's like, could you imagine saying no? Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Because remember, like, wasn't there a year that Venus like wore a skin colored something and they like she got in trouble or
that was at I think maybe at the French or it was somewhere, like something like that.
Like it was funny. And then even that one year that Roger's shoes had like too much red on the outsole.
Yeah.
And he had to change them. Anyways.
Just crazy old stuff.
Crazy old
stuff. It's like the balance of like, you know, the ritual and the, you know, like the.
Exactly.
Their old norms versus like modern stuff needs to be bridged a little bit.
Oh, and this is interesting. It says Wimbledon 2023 will begin on Monday, July 3rd and run until Sunday, July 16th. The reason for this change is to give players more time to adjust from clay to grass to avoid clashes with other major sporting events. Players and fans alike have embraced the change since it came about. Oh, in 2015. Well, that's not new. But it does feel like it's longer between the French and Wimbledon this year. But that might just be me.
Yeah. There was one year where I felt like it was like literally 2 or 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And like,
yeah.
Do we at least get a month now?
Yeah. I don't know. And then I just get like super, I get depressed like the last day of the French. And I'm like, ugh. But then Wimbledon's right around the corner. So, yes, Wimbledon relaxes dress code to allow women to wear dark undershorts. Makes me laugh.
Yeah,
thank you.
Something that should have happened already, but
yeah. So that's it. Wimbledon's coming up. We're excited. Woohoo!
And then soon enough, it'll be like summer hard courts.
Yes.
And speaking of which, yes. I was talking earlier or to you a while ago about how I was looking forward to going to the San Jose, and they moved it. They're getting rid of it.
What?
They're not getting rid of the tournament. They're moving it, and it's going to be a combined ATP, WTA, and D.C.
No,
way far away from California.
That's lame.
I think it's D.C. It's one of those summer hard courts where they're combining the event.
Well, Mubadala.
Yeah.
See you later.
Oh, man.
See you never.
Northern California. They're taking it away.
That was too easy.
Yeah, it was like pretty close for us to drive up there.
Templeton 60K. It's on.
There we go. We just have to make that a bigger party.
Tennis Nerd asked me what tournaments I was traveling to, and I said Templeton 60K.
And Santa Maria Open.
Yeah. Watch out. All kidding aside, it's a great tournament.
Yeah.
It's just not as glamorous. Yeah.
So. That's it.
Well, as always, this is always fun to chat about, and stay tuned for more fun chats like these. We're going to get more playtesters involved coming up very soon, very, very soon. And if you guys have more things that you want to hear about, let us know in the comments, and that's it.
Yeah, thanks for having.
Happy hitting. Woohoo!